Yeah, first and foremost, we want to give praises to Yahweh, Vashem, Yahushai, double understand the apostles and the elders, Ruel, a great millstone, and a blessed sanitation to the Achaeans in the four county yard, pushing the gospel in sincerity and truth, Shalom. You know, coming back with the next lesson to feed the elect, you know. This video was sent to my phone, you know. So I was going through this video, this video got some real meat inside, you know what I mean? Yeah, show these devils, all these devils. This is about the economy hitman, you know what I mean? Economical hitman, you know, he's going to, you know, different countries, you know, and you know what I mean? Give them like certain deals and then put them in some serious debts. You know, so much debts that I can't even pay back, you know what I mean? Yeah, so there's definitely, you know, say some things, you know what I mean? So let's let this video run, you know. That's for edification, you know what I mean, guys. Like I say, the most I skinning up these devil, you know what I mean? The most I bring in uncovering the nakedness, you know. Guy even mentioned Saddam Hussein in this video, you know, and what the devil them say, they said he had a nuclear weapon, and it wasn't the Saad, you know. They couldn't get him in the scheme, they couldn't like outsmart him, you know. Saddam was, he was a man at the head on, you know, he read them, he see them clear, he know the game, you know. Yeah, Saddam know the game, so I'm gonna let this video run, you know. Yeah, this video run from the top. You know, get this video to run. Get some volume.
I'm John Perkins. I'm a U.S. citizen, born in the United States, raised in the United States. I'm a former economic hitman. We work very much like some of the hitmen for the mafia because we're looking for a favor later. And mafia people have done this and gangsters have done this for ages. We just do it on a very large level with governments, with countries, huge level. And we're much more professional. And we do this in many ways, but perhaps the most common is that economic hitmen will identify a country that has resources our corporations covet, like oil. And then we arrange a huge loan to that country from the World Bank or one of its sister organizations. But the money never actually goes to the country. Instead, it goes to our own corporations to build big infrastructure projects in that country. Things that benefit a few very rich people in that country, as well as our own corporations, but don't help the majority of the people who are too poor. But these people, the poor people, are left holding a huge debt, and it's so huge that they can't possibly repay it. But in the process of trying to repay it, they create a situation where they can't afford to have good health programs or educational programs. So we economic hitmen go back in and we say, listen, you owe us a lot of money, you can't pay your debts, so give us a pound of flesh. Sell your oil real cheap to our oil companies, or vote with us on the next critical United Nations vote, or send troops in support of ours to someplace in the world, like Iraq.
Yeah, and Saraki, and this is exactly what's going on now in Venezuela, you know, with this oil crisis. You know what I mean? There's the same thing happening, how they collapse, how the economy collapse, because the economy hit my went today. And what they do, they assassinate Chavez. You know? Yeah, because it wasn't getting to come on their page. You know? This devil got a lot for pay for. You know what I mean? The same thing they do to Saddam Hussein too. You know? You know what I mean? They go in, hey, you know, praise and glory to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. You know, these devils go in, you see that they target to countries with natural resource. That's why these devils can't come out of Afghanistan up to this day. Even the devil Obama say, you know, when he when he was voting and be elected president, so he can bring the troop out. He came out of office. He spent two terms, came out, and these soldiers still in Afghanistan. You know? So this is what these devils do. You know what I mean? They covet land, they covet countries, they covet people, natural resources, people wealth. You know? This is how these devils move, you know?
And in that way, we've really managed to create this empire. Because the fact of the matter is, we write the laws. We control the World Bank. We control the IMF. We even control the United Nations to a large degree. And so we write the laws. So the things economic hitmen are not illegal. Putting countries in huge debt and then demanding favors in return. That's not illegal. It should be.
Yeah, they write the laws. And there's in the scripture. You know? And who won the IMF and the banks them? The Rothschilds, the Rockefeller, Goldman Sachs, the Lehman Brothers. They own the banks. They is who run this world. You know, they is who write laws and legislation. All these leaders where they have these puppets. You know, them is the real mafia in this world. You know? These devil, you understand? He say with the economical hitman, whatever he doing is not illegal because they write the laws. You know? This is Isaiah chapter 10, verse 1. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decree, and that write grievousness with which they have prescribed. You know what I mean? And this is what these devils do. You know what I mean? These devils write their own law. So when they do, when they covet and do the wickedness, you know what I mean? They already set the law. You know what I mean? Yeah. Let me read the scripture again. This is Isaiah chapter 10, verse 1. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decree, and that write grievousness which they have prescribed. You know what I mean? And that's what these devils do. You know? These devil got a lot for PA for. You know?
It isn't. Characteristics of an empire is that it enforces its currency on the rest of the world. And we've really done that with the dollar. So in 1971, the United States had a tremendous amount of debt, and a lot of this was a result of the Vietnam War. And we were on the gold standard. Some of these other countries decided to call in their debts in gold because they didn't trust the dollar. Nixon refused to pay in gold, in fact took us off the gold standard because he knew he couldn't pay in gold. We didn't have the value. And so very quickly after that, we went on the oil standard. And I was a large part of that deal that we struck with Saudi Arabia, insisting that OPEC only sell oil in dollars. And so suddenly the dollar moves from the gold standard to the oil standard, which in many respects is a much more important standard because oil is intrinsically more valuable than gold in this day and age. And so suddenly the world can only buy oil for dollars, and the dollar is a very, very important currency. Today the United States once again is a bankrupt country. We have huge amounts of debt, more debt than any country's ever had in the history of the world before. And if some other country to call that debt in a currency other than the dollar, we'd be in very, very serious trouble. Right now, they're only calling it in dollars because oil is the big commodity and you can only buy oil in dollars. But Saddam Hussein threatened to sell oil for something other than dollars just before he was taken down. Mark Hitman failed to corrupt leaders of other countries, as I failed with Omar Torrijos in Panama and Jaime Roldos in Ecuador. It doesn't often happen, but when it does, then the jackals are sent in. And these are people who overthrow governments or assassinate their leaders. So when I failed with Jaime Roldos in Ecuador and Omar Torrijos in Panama, the jackals went in and assassinated them. On the few occasions where neither the economic hitmen nor the jackals are successful, then and only then do we send in the military. And this is exactly what happened in Iraq. Economic hitmen could not corrupt Saddam Hussein, could not bring him around. The jackals couldn't take him out, and so the military was sent in. The first time we sent the military in 1991, we destroyed his military and figured that he had been sufficiently chastised that now he would come around. And so during the 90s, the economic hitmen went back in to try to bring Saddam Hussein around, but he wouldn't give in. If he had, he'd still be running the country and we'd be selling him jets and tanks and everything else he wanted. But he didn't give in. The jackals couldn't assassinate him. His security forces were very good. And he had a lot of lookalike doubles, so his own security men didn't know whether they were guarding him or a double. So neither the economic hitmen nor the jackals succeeded the second time with Saddam Hussein. And at that point, we sent in the military again. And this time we took him out. And the rest is history.
So it's how these devils, it's how these devils do it. You know what I mean? Yeah, these devils got a economically hitmen. You know what I mean? The jackals who they send in to assassinate these leaders. You know, if they don't subject to their ordinance. You know what I mean? To their ordinances. You know what I mean? It's how these devils move. You know? Yeah, and if we say earlier in the video that America is in so much debt, you know, I mean, I think it's over 20 trillion in debt, you know, and destruction coming to America, you know, you simple-minded Jakes living in the land, you know, you believe America can keep going on and on, but America can face the same thing that Venezuela going through, you know, or like Mexico and certain parts of the world going through, famine coming there, because the economy can collapse. You know, the economy can collapse because they have more debt more than any other nation, and they cannot pay the debt. They over $20 trillion in debt. You know, yeah, over $20 trillion in debt. You know, I mean, they cannot pay the debt. You know, there's Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 5. He said, yeah, because he transgressed by wine, he is a proud man. You know, these devil proud. These devil tell you plain what he's been doing. Economy hit men, they going to corrupt these nation, you know, to get what the resources, you know. That's why these devil can't come out to the Middle East up to this day, you know. And the matter of fact is, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai have them there too. You know what I mean? Yeah, you know, they're there to steal your resources. These devils are the cancer of the earth. You know, Yahweh Shai gotta come back and take these devils down. You know, these devils need to come out. You know what I mean? But like I said, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai is skinning up the nakedness. You know, he said, yeah, because he transgressed by wine, there's a democracy. They're going with it. You see, as the Most High say, the serpent was more subtle than any other beast in the field. So Esau is a crafty beast. He's a crafty creature. You know, he come smooth. He come real smooth and tricky. You know what I mean? Yeah. He said, he is a proud man. Need to keep it at home. He sent economical hitman in this country to overthrow this country and to get control of the resources. See, this a man don't keep at home. You know what I mean? He enlarged his desire as hell, destruction. You know, when you see they do, when economical hitman in a succeed, they send in the jackals who the assassinators, who assassinate them. And if they fail, who they send in the military? That the word hell means destruction. You know what I mean? And is as death and cannot be satisfied. Salaki. And cannot be satisfied, but gather it unto him all nation and heap it unto him all people. And this is what these devils do. When you can't pay the debt, they say, well, you know what? You can use your military, you can vote for us, you can join with what? You join with the beast, which is NATO or the EU, you know, and you're going to fight the war, you know what I mean? Yeah, you know what I mean? So, this is what this devil is doing, you know what I mean? Yeah, and the devil telling on himself right now. This devil telling on himself. He was part of the economy hitman. So this devil telling on himself. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's I jump down to Yeah, there's a yeah, and that's read Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, this with five. Yeah, that's it. You know, I want to do the video too long. You know what I mean? So, yeah. So this, yeah, this is what this devil is doing. You know, this devil is coming here, coming the people, coming these other nation land for the resources. You know what I mean? You know, they come for the resources. You know, and they send in the economical hitman. You know, the jackals, and if they fail, they send in with the military. You know, the military is strong, so they're sending the military to destroy, you know, and take it by what force, you know what I mean? Yeah, they take it by force. I'm saying that, you know, like this quick precept here. This is Micah. This is Micah chapter 2, verse 1. It says, woe to them that devise iniquity and work it evil upon their beds. You know what I mean? They plan this well. You know, they planned it well, you know what I mean, to go into overthrow this country, deceive them, you know what I mean. He say, and when the morning is light, they practice it because it is in the power of their hands, and it's the power of these banking family hands to do this thing, to go into this land and lend them a huge amount of loan that they can't even pay back. You know what I mean? This is exactly what they do, you know. It's verse 2, and they covet field, the people natural resources, they covet field, they take control of it, you know what I mean? It's a, and take them by violent, if the economical hitman fail, the jackal fail, they're sending the military, you know, they're sending the military to what, take it by violent, you know what I mean? It's a, and houses, and take them away, so the oppressing man and his house, even a man and his heritage. You know what I mean? That's how these devils move. You know, like I say, America right now is over $20 trillion in debt. And so these destruction coming day, you know, famine, you know, all kind of pestilence, race war. You know what I mean? Then I got the RFID microchip. You know, this coming, you know what I mean? Coming, because America can't pay back the debt, you know? There's over $20 million in, over $20 trillion in debt, you know what I mean? They can't pay the back, you know? So with that, always was edifying to the elect. I want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh Shai, double honors to the apostles and the elders who rule a great millstone, and a blessed sanitation to the Akiyams in the four corners of the earth, to push in the gospel and sincerity and truth. Shalom.